Morvan. First of all, everybody knows you because of Milli Vanilli, Girl, You Know It's True, and it's amazing what you achieved back then. Also, a lot of people want to know about their story, blah, blah, blah. They heard so many versions, but
it was really cool because, I mean, the people that were on board were like top international professional who get awards every year in Cannes for doing commercial. Ogilvy was involved. Dara was a director. And in about, we did 3 minutes. The spot is 3 minutes. And then we did a bunch of like 20 seconds ads. But the one thing that people don't know is that in the creative meeting, we were talking about how we should go about like promoting, this thing that we're working
on.
They said, hey, we wanted to have a voice announce the menu. And I said, hey, what about me singing the menu?
Well, it was a journey to find the real me. And it brought me here to this beautiful country, the Netherlands. It's a country with a lot of freedom. It's a country where you can really be whoever you want to be. To be yourself, you know, and that for me, being yourself is this whole discovery, is to be myself again, to be the real me. Well, I came from a totally different planet, and I was living the most unreal life you could ever imagine. We were so famous. I was 24 years old. There's no way I would be sitting here like I'm sitting right now. We'd be running through that back door over there, because the girls trying to touch their hair, trying to get the phone number, it wouldn't be just one, it would be the whole room. Girls went crazy the moment we did. Girl, you know it's true. Until they find out it wasn't true.
Breaking news, Milli Vanilli does not sing for real.
Well, suddenly we were the most talked about artist and judged by the whole world. Hey, little buddy. He's a little bit like me, see? I've changed from Milli Vanilli into the real me over the years.
Ah, you're so beautiful.
I live a normal life now, and it feels just great.
Can you take us back to the old Fab one more time?
But of course I can. He's still around. I can't go get him. I was always a performer as a kid. It was just in me. Loved it. I was born to do this. I know what it means to be myself now. And this is why I want people to hear me sing, for real.
My hair is a mess, man.
Blame it on the rain.
Because I found the real me again, those guys at KFC asked me to sing about their real chicken. I think that's cool, right? To be real is the essence of life, my brother.
All right, man, let's do this.
Chicken 1-2, chicken 1-2, okay.
Be real and enjoy 100% real chicken. KFC is finger licking good.
Yes, yes,
oh, come on, give me boom.
How do I want to be remembered? An icon of real, maybe. Who knows?
I was surprised that, not that you could sing, I knew you could sing, but when I hear the texture, and this is very important to producers right now, when I hear the texture of a voice, and it even made me remind me to Michael Jackson. But there are a couple of things that you do there when you're singing. It's like, and you almost going falsetto, but not really falsetto.
Right.
And it gives this Michael touch.
Well, it's funny because I've been dragging that with me for many years, because the first time that I performed in America, on Arsenio Hall, was one of the biggest talk show hosts in America at the time. He promoted our performance for like a month. And right. then on the 30th day, there they were. And we performed the song called We Can Get It On. You can find that performance on YouTube as well.
Okay.
And it came out in the Los Angeles Times, Fab Morvan reminiscent of Michael Jackson. I was like, wow, that's cool.
I didn't know that, bro. I didn't know that. You never told me. How come?
Those people always thought that I have the texture. It's not planned. It's just the way, I guess, our apparatus is kind of having similar.
Yeah.
And hey, man. If people hear that, I'm like, cool, you know.
I want to tell the story a little bit of how we did it. So I started the instrumental more or less in, where was I living back then? I was living in Romania. And then I went to visit my cousin, who was Natural Bone Grooves. Everybody from the 90s will always remember NBG and Natural Bone Grooves, Groovebird. And he has a big studio in Antwerp as well. So I started mixing a little bit. And then we have to say very much thank you to our beautiful friend, Joy. Huh? She will be watching too. And Joy told me, Jerry, I have a very, very good friendship with Fab from Milli Vanilli. Really? Yeah, I'll put you in contact. And I was, I mean, though people say I am a superstar or I'm a legend, I'm sorry, I'm not a legend until I'm dead. But anyway, that's another topic. I was like talking to a real superstar because I was playing all these records too many times. I swear to God, sometimes I was hating the songs already. Sorry that I'm telling you, bro. But then we got in touch and it was like, click. We were like brothers in that same second when we talked.
The vibe
was exactly there. And
yeah.
you started writing the thing at home, right? And we were back and forth listening. And then you did the recordings. You sent me the vocals. I was in Belgium. I mixed them there. And then I came here to Romania. I finished mastering it. And the rest of the story, you know, celebrate. I'm going to put the link back again. Now we can listen a little bit to the song.
It's an incredible record because of the fact that, you know, that's what I look for. And every time I start working with a producer, there's this first mission that comes to mind. We never know when the record is going to come out. So what I try to do, and, you know, it happened with us because we are made like this is how we think. That's why I was like, man, Jerry is a dude. We said, we're going to make a record, but let's try to make a record that doesn't move in time. So like this, whenever it comes out, whenever you're going to hear it, you're going to be like, wow, when did I come out? You don't know. It's got the element of modern music, but it's got all the element of a vintage flair as well. You know,
when you're able to
with vintage
and fresh,
and all, you know, and all that, because it has a little disco flavor to it, it's like, wow, this is like. And those are the kind of records that I
sing it. Sing it a little bit a cappella again. We celebrate it. It's our song.
I can't remember it right now, bro. People, like when I'm done, you know, talking with you, I go back because I was in a session. I go back to my session, so I got so many other things in my head right now. I can't.
I'm cutting this out. Don't worry about that.
It's cool, but
I don't even remember myself.
Celebrate. It is a classic record that people will play at parties and it will become a staple.
Yeah.
Because it's had beautiful touch. Every time I hear it, it makes me smile, bro. It really puts a smile on my face and it's like, wow, I'm so glad that this is our record.
Yeah.
I'm so glad.
Beside that, the word celebrate means a lot to us because we're celebrating our friendship. We're celebrating the amazing coming back that you had and the way where you are nowadays doing so many different things that I don't think we are allowed to talk right now about that. But it has to do with the United States. It's very international, everything what you're doing, because Fab is not only doing the singing thing, he's doing different stuff as well. We'll get the information later. Not today, I'm really sorry, because it's still there. You know, putting all the elements together because it has to be a bomb. So what I say a lot of, to the young producer, maybe not only young, but a little bit older young, and success is not made like this. So if we go a little bit back to the Milli Vanilli story, never believe any one of you that someone saw something, brought to the studio, next day they were superstars. No, that's not the way it works. That's not the way it works. It's the patience game that we have to control completely.
And the thing is, you know, regarding Milli, that's an incredible story that with so many layers and people involved. But the one thing I will say that it went so fast, but we came as fast as it disappeared. Right. You know, we came like the supernova, and we were gone.
Yeah.
And it, I'm telling you, I'm so glad that I'm here today, you know, that I'm alive.
Is it a blessing now for you? Though it was a nightmare back then. Do you think it's a blessing for you now?
It's a blessing for me.
I see it like a blessing for you.
Yeah, man, because, you know, like, the one thing...
because you're working with me now. That's what you have to say. Because I'm working with you now.
Right. But the one thing, I read something, because I did a lot of reading, and one thing struck me. I read something, I think it was Plato or Aristotle's, you know, philosopher, Greek philosophers, and they were talking about depression. Right. And they were saying that you have to face your depression dead on because of the fact that it will arm you for the next step that you will take in life. It will shape you into who you're supposed to become.
Right.
And that for me, like in my process, in my recovery process, I read that in the midst of it. And it really makes sense to me. I was like, whoa, I'm glad that I took it dead on. I didn't waver or was afraid of taking it dead on. I took it dead on, not knowing what I was doing. It was just like a reflex. I was like, I want to stay here. I want to keep doing what I love, which is music, but I'm not feeling well. I'm not good at all.
Of course.
So what did I do? What did I do? I focused on the one thing that I had to take to get back, and that was my health. And when I got my physical health kind of together, then it gave me my physical strength, gave me mental strength. And that's when I read another book, The Body and the Mind, and I understood, like, oh, the body and the mind are connected. There is no buts about it.
No.
It's just, no, there's no doubt. It's a fact, 100%. So then my work, my inner work on my inner self has been to make sure that those two stay combined. So I worked on my physical, and the mental and the physical were growing and getting better. And that's when I was able to start making the right decisions.
Right.
And when your decision making is on point, what does that do? It connects you to the next dot, into the next dot, into the next dot.
Yeah.
And that's how I've been traveling, you know, through time.
Well, you see, you know, this is amazing value that you're giving to everybody watching us right now, because a lot of young musicians, DJs, artists, even entrepreneurs, they don't stop to analyze the thing and then really go for it and make something out of that analyze that they did normally from themselves, you know. So you should start analyzing yourself. It's like Fab is saying, you have the depression, okay, you have it, but don't run away from it. Face it, fix it, go for it. If it's you had a depression caused by an event, this is very important. I'm going to talk like the therapist that I am. You had the depression because of an event. Other people have depression because they have a mental issue. This is differently. But the approach is the same. Go face the problem that you have, admit it, then go look for help, because that's when you're a really cool person. It's not cool to say, I don't need a doctor. This is bullshit, people. You have to take the help that is offered out there, even for me if you want, and then start working on that. And never this is very important, never let a depression or a mental health disorder or whatever stop you from reaching your dream. Fab is here, the perfect example. You know, I mean, you guys know the story. You've been watching now probably already the the video that we put here down, down the link, sorry. And he was fucking big. And then all of a sudden, this was really from one day to the other, you know. So very long path to build up what you guys were. And from one day to the other, because of whatever bullshit happened, boom, down.
And
then you came back. Then you come really back.
It's the hardest, because, you know, fame, when the fame disappears slowly, just like the temperature of water. You know, it's super hot, it's lukewarm, and it gets colder and colder. You know, but you have like a couple of years. No, it was just from one day to the next.
Right.
So the trauma was, and when we talk about bullying, I mean, I know what it's like to be bullied. I know what it's like. And this is why I tell to people that are being bullied, it's not about you, it's about them.
Yes.
Don't take it personally. It's about them. They have a problem. They're dealing with something, and the only way they can deal with something, their way of dealing with something, is to hate on somebody else. That's what it is.
But now, hold on a second, because it's so beautiful and so strong what you just said. But people will then ask, how do I do that? How do I not hate that person? How do I really, because I know it's about the other one, but still I'm very hurt. What advice could you give them? How to...
You know what? I give you an example. The producer, Frank Farian, to go back to the Milli Vanilli story, someone asked me like, how do you feel about Frank Farian? And I was like, listen, I had to take a very important step in my life. And it was to that anger that I felt, you know, towards him and what he had done to me, because he was all premeditated. He knew exactly what he was doing. We just fell into a trap, not knowing, no experience in the music industry.
Yeah, how can you know?
Exactly. We had the hunger, and he played with that, and we fell for it. There's more detail to the story, there's more layers. But the point I'm trying to make is that when you are in that situation, you know, and people take advantage of the fact that, because people sometimes know that you're not well, you know? So what you can do is, when you realize that, is don't, the anger that you have, forgive. It's the best thing you can do. Forgive them for who they are, and then forgive yourself. But forgive them before you can forgive yourself for letting things happen to you. Because sometimes when something happens to you, you hate yourself. Why did I let that happen? Why did I do that? Forgive the person who did that to you, and then forgive yourself. Once you take that step, it changes everything. And then the anger that I had towards that person, because, you know, if you stay in anger, it will stop you. It will bring it, the soil.
Of course.
The soil, you live, your own body, your own temple will be affected. Mold is going to start to grow. And you know what happened? Termites. And then you're going to be eaten from within. And then your vibe, you won't vibe. Nobody's going to want to be around you, because it's obvious. When you're not right, people know it. They go, ew.
Yep. Ciao.
They don't want to have with you. Yep. So, like I said, forgive this person, forgive them, love yourself. When you start to love yourself, woo!
I think that's the most difficult part. It's simple, but it's the most difficult part for a lot of people, you know, to reach that level. I have a similar story.
It's a step-by-step process.
Definitely. It's again, we say it's a patience game. Patience game. Now, I see that in myself, of course, not on that level, but when I put music on my new track on Facebook, then they start commenting, hey, nice track, where can I buy it, when it's coming out, blah, 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 blah. Okay, but Facebook is just like another office place. And you know, at each office, you have a guy who is the dick, you know. And Facebook, exactly the same. Yeah, and then all of a sudden, between all those beautiful messages, there's one guy.
Yeah.
Jerry, this track is so shit. You're not doing the same music like back then. And honestly, it's not even worth to follow you anymore. Okay. So now, and when I give therapy, I always give people two choices. So choice number one, I'm Spanish. I have boiling blood, trust me. So I could definitely, with all the rights that I have, and I'm entitled even, to answer the guy and say, who the fuck are you? Have you studied music? Are you a producer? No, so go back to your job, and if you want to be pissed at someone, go to somewhere else. You see? No.
That's right.
But I choose the second option. And second option is exactly the same what you say. It's kindness. And kindness is, I think, the most powerful weapon, if you want to call it like that, in the world. So my answer was, my dear blah, blah, blah. I don't remember the name. Here it goes. First of all, thank you so much for being honest to me. I swear that for my next track, I'm going to put even more effort in, so you're going to like the track as well, and I can make you a good day with it. So thank you for your comment. Have a beautiful day. Big hug and big kiss. The word kiss for a lot of people is really like, oh, you know. So in that moment, what I do is taking him his negativity weapon away.
Yeah.
I am attacking him, let's say, with kindness. Of course, he has no possibility of answering or responding on that comment anymore, because what is he going to say, you know? And that's it. And I have to say, it happened more than one time. And some of those times, I went to that profile of that guy. Normally, it's a person who is not even following you, or not even friends on Facebook. And I went and I asked him, hey, my friend, are you okay? Did you have a bad day or something? I mean, because of the comment. And then, boom, they come down. Again, because they approached them with kindness. And say, yeah, man, you have no idea. My wife just left me and I'm complete. I don't, you know, you can delete the comment if you want. I said, no, I'm leaving it there. I think it's really nice. You know, so if I can help you with something, we're friends now, you can always write me. When you talk like this to people, they will always be feeling relaxed with you, and they're always feeling that good vibe that you're talking about the whole time, because that's what it is about. And I think more of the people who's listening to us should try that out. And believe me, it works. It really works.
I have another example.
Oh, yeah. Go on.
People,
you're learning a lot here. You know that, eh? Everybody watching this, you're learning a lot from Mr. Fab Morvan. Well, he's my brother. Amen. Just say Mr. Fab Morvan because of the recording. He's my brother.
But take this out. I'll give you an example. When I was talking about, it's not about you, it's about them, what they feel, and they try to lash out. And this person wrote to me, and they said, if I recall, they said, oh, I used to hate you. And I was like, okay. Because I know there's some people who like me. You know, it's either you love me or you hate me. It's nothing in between.
Yes.
And one of the reasons why he hated me is because I was strong enough to kept on going. Because I kept on going. I'm still here. And to some people, it makes them feel very uncomfortable because the mirror comes up. Their mirror comes up and they look at themselves. And they look at themselves as failures because of the fact that they probably were doing the same thing I was doing or doing something else. And then because they didn't pursue it, they didn't have the kahunas, the balls. To keep going, to fight for themselves. Because essentially you do is, You give up on no one but yourself. And that, my friend, is the hardest let down. Because my philosophy, I don't want to have any regrets. We only live once. So everything is based on that. I give my whole, because I don't want to regret. I don't want any regret.
Yeah, me exactly the same. I don't want to be laying, I hope it's not happening like this, you know, but 83 years old at the hospital because of whatever reason, and you know it's the end. And then you start thinking, say, fuck, I should have done this. I should have done that. Why not? Why didn't I try that? Or even more vulgar, why did I fuck that chick? Just because I thought her feet were ugly. You know, we should stop being so picky, and we should start using our common sense. That's the most important thing. We have to use our common sense.
And you know, and I said, that's why I love Star Wars.
Oh, there we go. I've never seen one. Do you know that? Not even one? No. Never. That's a must now.
Growing up as a kid, you know, it was really cool because Yoda was my, without knowing it, you know, I was always into Bruce Lee. Bruce Lee is one of my mentors, one of my heroes. Okay. But Yoda is also one of them. You know, the way he spoke, it was very weird the way he spoke because, you know, it was subtitled. For me, it was in French, you know.
Oh, yeah, because people don't know that because you are half American, half French.
No. I'm Creole French. I lived in America for about 26 years. You know, I have an American passport as well. But it's because I lived there for so long, so I'm almost like a native, and I was there at a young age. But
yeah, but sometimes we speak in French because I'm very lucky to speak French thanks to my grandmother. And you know, we're speaking in English, blah, 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 and then all of a sudden he's changing to French, so I'm just following, or the other way around. You know, it's like probably people would listen to us and say, "What is wrong with those artists? You know, what are they drinking or what are they doing?"
Sometimes it's more comfortable. Sometimes it's more comfortable to use one or the other, depending on what we're talking about, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Show business is normally in English.
Exactly.
But private stuff is French. Okay, let's go back to the Star Wars thing. I think it's very interesting.
Star Wars, like, you know, la force, the force. You know, this thing.
Did you just say it in Italian?
La forza. Oh, it's Italian, right?
Si.
Yes. Yeah,
La fuerza in Spanish.
La fuerza.
Right. And then la forza, yeah. Italiano.
Yeah, because when I was younger, I spoke a little bit too, you know, because I used to go to Riccione, Rimini, you know. Tu è l'unica ragazza per me questa sera.
Wow, bravo, bello, bravo. Per tutti gli parlanti italiani.
See, so when they were talking about this thing, you know, and I was really interested by the force, you know, and I started to look at the world around me like different, like, also there's something invisible, and there is an invisible world out there. It is just a fact, and they're negative. And they're positive people. And it's just like that. And some of them became, I mean, I don't like, you know, I don't like to use the word negative or positive. It's just they became this way because of action equal reaction and their surroundings. And others had a chance to recover from whatever, because everyone goes through their ups and downs, and people fall, stand back up, recover, reinvent, and evolve. And some people are more evolved than others. And I think that our goal as evolved people that we've become, because, yeah, you know, we've been here. Oh, sorry, cut. You there? Okay.
We're here.
Because we fell and stood back up and reinvent ourselves and have evolved, I feel the need. It's been with me forever, and it's been with you as well, because we started with music, because music is love. We give to music through music. But through the years, I started talking to people, to my friends. I've always done that, talking to my friends and trying to make them feel better. It was weird. It was like
a natural thing. You do. I have to tell something about that, but go on.
You know, And then music was like, we give through music, we create love through music, we give our all through music. And then I discovered that I could also talk to people. And when I discovered that I could inspire people, I kept doing it and been doing it ever since. And my brother, Jerry, man, like, I felt like there was something. And my initial reaction is to give, because it's something in our body and you have the same.
Right.
Because knowing you came to my rescue as a fellow artist because you wanted good for me, you know, yes. And that
one vice versa.
Give good to someone.
Right. I have to say something very important here. Sorry, I'm going to cut you off. But so people know also, for the people who don't know, I am a bipolar patient. I have a bipolar disorder 2. And though I am on medication since many years, I don't do drugs, I don't do alcohol, anything at all. But still, medication is not really healing because mental health disorder is not, you cannot heal it. Let's put that way. So I have my doubts during the year. And then I call Fab because he is the master motivator that I can really swear you guys. And then, I don't know, either he starts singing on the phone, either he starts talking bullshit on the phone. So I'm starting to laugh my ass off, but that's the kind of therapy he's doing. And then he just speaks to you or he sends me messages. I have those voice messages. Sometimes when I don't feel good, I cannot reach him. I listen to them. He has this relaxed voice and the things he says, it's like having the master of meditation brother on the phone whenever I want. And this is amazing. So again, we don't have to forget, I'm a DJ. I came a long way, and the long way includes playing. Girl, you know, it's true. I heard it so many times, so I think that, girl, you know, it's not true at the end, but he's just cheering up my life, you know. It's amazing.
I just had an idea.
Oh, there we go.
Right part. And I think we talked about it, but I think
Which one?
Go select the best ones, man, and build a track about it, around it. That would be dope.
So the best one, bro. The best things that you were sending me the voice messages.
Yeah, that's
a good idea. Wow, that's a good idea.
That'd be dope.
Maybe we do a really good house track, guys, with some bits and parts from what he was sending me on audio. And
yeah,
it's maybe even going to motivate. I mean, without the word, maybe it will motivate you. That's a good idea, bro. That's a good idea.
Yes. So we do like deep house, like, you know, and because some of them were very special because they came from the heart, man. Anything that's done with love and from the heart is powerful. I call it like it's potent. The energy is potent because it's love. Ain't nothing stronger than love.
Right.
And when you find love in yourself, you can start to love the world and love yourself, and then you're going to connect with others, and whatever your mission is in life, then you can start to like do what you need to do for yourself.
Right.
But you have to love yourself, because that will give you the strength to wake up in the morning and say, hey, I'm going to do that for myself, for me, myself, and I.
Hey, bro, so which advice would you give to all those shit? Well, we're going to see my belly. I got a belly, actually. A fat one now. I don't even know how to get rid of this shit. Anyway.
Time to work out.
What?
Time to work out.
Yeah, you know, me and workout, we were never really good friends.
Yeah,
we didn't look at each other. But walking, Jay. Jay, I'm walking. Jay is my manager, you know. Wait, let me show the people my manager. Come on. Come over here. So, here we are. Jay, my manager.
That's right.
Oh, you met him already. Well, Fab is here. I think he's sleeping a little bit. He has been reading so many contracts and shit. He's dead.
Spanish, or what language does he speak?
Actually, I don't understand it, but I suppose he speaks Romania because I rescued him from Romania. you know. And he was 6 months old, and I don't know, they wanted to kill him or something, I don't remember. And I said, what? You know what? I take this puppy with me. And they told me, yeah, because of the difference of color. I never heard that, because he's very platinum. And you see, this is diamond pure. And he has pedigree, actually. And they said, because of the color, he will be a depressed dog. So I said, it's the biggest bullshit I ever heard. But if it's like that, it's good, because I'm depressed too. So we're both depressed, you know. So we, but believe me, this dog has everything but depression. He's, how quiet, how you see him here, he's an ass. He doesn't go out to pee. He goes out to see, like, who can I kill you? To kill you today, you know. Right, Jay, that's you. I'm going back to sleep. But Fab, what would you tell to the younger producers, not really to the younger producers who are hungry and everything, and they start going head over heels, and that's normally. You like my kitchen?
As long as you can cook something from A to Z and have bring it on the table and eat it.
I would never say that I can cook. I always say I can survive, but I'm not a cook. So for each lady here who is interested, who probably was interested until the point that I said, I can't cook, well, I can't cook. But I'm very good at doing sandwiches. Wow. The best ones in town. Young producers, head over heels, too hungry.
Okay. I'll tell you.
Where are they going to fail?
My advice to them is, first of all, make sure that you keep working on your skills. That's very important. Because sometimes people do, the young producers of today, they because of, you know, we have software now, because before you needed an engineer.
Right.
Now you can use software. And what a lot of people are doing, they're doing a lot. They create a lot. A lot of them don't finish. So I would say, work on your skills. Start and finish what you're doing, but also don't send out or don't release something before it's ready just because you want to release. Make sure right. that it's finished. Make sure you come with love, and make sure that you play it for people that you trust. That people you trust, and don't be afraid of the truth. If it ain't good, if they tell you it ain't good, it's actually great, because, you know, some people are constructive with their criticism. So if someone tells you, I don't like it, well, you have to, why don't you like it? And then from there, you can take some of the criticism and you can make yourself better, because it's right. about getting. So every track should be better than the last. That's how you should look at it. Not just make. No, each track has to be better than the last. When I write a song, when I make a track, I try to make sure that it's as good as the last one. You have to raise the standard with everything that you do. That's important, because then you create growth, and growth is necessary.
Yeah. That's second, exactly the same what I think.
Right, and my other advice would be, make sure you use an attorney when it comes to papers, because it's show business. There's the show part. Oops, sorry.
Yeah, it's cool.
It's the battery's telling me. It's about me.
Oh, your battery is going down?
Yeah, it's going down.
Fab Morvan is getting out of juice, but only the battery. I mean, only the phone.
So what I was going to say, if when things are going well and people say, hey, here's a contract, make sure you don't do that.
Yeah, good. I like that.
don't drink the Kool-Aid. Make sure you get an attorney on board that's going to tell you, because if you sign the wrong thing, it could hurt you for the rest of your life.
This is a very, very strong advice. I always advise also to the artist to be artist and to leave the business in hands of people who's doing business, who don't understand the artistic part. Because it's like in every business, when you put your emotion into business, then you're lost. Business is business. So okay, people like you and me, we've been in this like for all our lives, so we understand the contracts and everything, but still we let them take by somebody who knows about the laws, because it's just like one phrase, like Fab said, can change your life for the worse, not for the better. You see,
time is one of the most, hear me out, everybody. Time is one of the most precious commodity. Money, you can lose money, you can make it back, but time. Once lost, it's gone. Gonzo.
I changed my philosophy. And I stopped saying one day, time is money. I started with time is value. And since then, my life changed, boom, like 500x, you know. So, because people do things because of the money, because of the fame, because of the girl, because of the champagne. Those are the one day flies, or maybe they fly a little bit longer, but that's not the purpose, you know. So I always say also, it's not about the goal itself. It's about the road. If you are not in love, but deeply, deeply in love with the path to go to that goal you set for yourself, and you don't love all the stones, all the backstabbing, all the problems, all the headaches, and all the joys, of course, in between of that way. If you're not in love with all those elements, then you're doing something wrong.
Well, but the thing on the journey, on the path, whether you want to become an attorney or a musician, a producer, a welder, or a wood maker, you know, a menuisier.
Forgot the word. Well, I'm a musician. Right.
And what it is the passion, your passion for what it is that you do has to be so strong, because that will allow you to take punches, blah, 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 but also to take him on. They'll make you stronger. You will bob and weave and avoid some of it. But in the end, you get closer to what you're going to become and what you're going to accomplish.
Yep.
And your passion will guide you there. But you have to nurture. You have to water it constantly.
Right.
And how do you do that? By staying curious. Stay curious about what you do.
Stay curious. Learn.
Will engender, like, you know, your drive. So curiosity pushes your drive, and your drive pushes you to accomplish and to evolve and to continue to do what you need to do. If you're not the type of person that wants to evolve, you like to go like this, it's okay if you're fine with that, but you have to be fine with that. But if something in the back of your mind is like a pimple, like a little pimple in the back of your head keeps on itching, that means you want more out of life.
Yeah.
You want to grow, you want to evolve.
Yeah.
You want to become the best version of yourself.
Yeah.
Then go for it. Don't be afraid.
Yeah.
Fear, you got to remove that fear.
Fear is unnecessary.
It's not necessary. But you know, sometimes fear can also, for me, fear can also be a motivator. Like, it pushes me.
If it's a motivator, yes. Of course.
Yeah.
Of course.
That thing was, I don't want to fail. I want to get to that point. I'm going to be tired as hell, but I'm going to do it because I don't want to fail. I want to make that mark. And I push myself. Oof.
In my life, success is when I can say I didn't reach the goal. Fuck, I had a lot of fun working towards the goal, because the goal is a 1 second thing in the timeline, and the having fun going there, it's like years maybe, and those years you're having so much fun. People asking me also like, but you did a lot of hits, you had Corazon, you had this, you had that. No, hold on, let me explain you the timeline. Here I worked my ass off. I have to say, my Spanish ass off is very interesting. And working, till I had my new record out. Nothing happened. Or my first record, nothing happened. In between of those nothing happened, there were a lot of records that nobody even wanted to listen to. Not even the consumer, not even the record company. And then you have that boom. Let's say, Corazon. And then I had another track called Fuck You. Okay? It's beautiful, two words actually. I love to say them. And the people don't know that between Curaçao timeline, between Curaçao and Fuck You, there were another 140 records that I did, which were flop, 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 not working, not working, not working, not working. This way people say, I had enough, I don't work anymore. And then you lost the game 100% because if you stop, you lost. But then I kept on going because I liked the music making itself, the studio, the sounds, the mixing, the mastering. That's where I had really the fun. And then when there was a hit, hurrah, we have a hit, but I want to go back to the studio and make another song, another song, another song. So what is the thing where that I was enjoying the most? The hit itself? No. I was enjoying the most the doing music, the daily life, going to the studio, coming back, talking with musicians. But that was the thing where I was in love with. I always say the hits were just collateral damage of the beautiful life I was living, or still live for sure.
Yeah. Okay. Hold on. I'm going to have to change a place. We'll cut that out. Okay. Yeah, because I have to charge.
Oh, yeah. So I like the way this is just people need, it's learning, you know.
Okay, because I have to. Otherwise, this is. I'm far away from the modem, so I don't know how good. Can you still see me?
Yeah, yesterday it wasn't that good from there, but let's go on. That's it.
Because it was better over there, right?
It's good.
It's good. Okay, hold on.
It's really good. Light. Actually going to smoke a cigarette.
Turn a little bit of light. Get some flowers. Beautiful. My artwork.
Did you do that?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, man.
Okay. Oh, you're going to show that in the interview. Wow. Okay, keep it like that. And we're going to start again from here. Okay, my friends, we do a change of location from the site from our friend Fab, because what we are looking at is another kind of art that our man Fab Morvan is doing. So Fab, tell me a bit about that, because I didn't see that before. You never showed me.
You know what's that about? It's called the Confused Dictator.
The Confused Dictator.
A dictator, because you can see he has a general, you know, okay. He has an arm.
That's a uniform. Yeah.
Right. It's about power. That's what it's about. It's about people gaining power. They were at one point in their life, and when they get power, they get confused by power. They become evil. The eyes are like, you know. And then they want to hypnotize and they want to manipulate others because of this power gain.
Okay.
It's about the system.
It's really about the system. And what about the ears? Because I see like kind of nails or paws or.
Yeah, no, because on top of it, yeah. You know, there's like what you call in taupe.
Okay.
You know what it's called? In taupe?
Yeah.
Right?
Say it in French.
That's us, the taupe is on top, and the taupe is trying to find its way in the ground, right?
Uh-huh.
That's what it is. So it's trying to find its way to the truth, to the light.
What about the ears?
Oh, the ears are like the paws of the taupe. That's what it is.
Bueno, en español, es un topo encima de la cabeza.
Yeah.
Un topo.
Yeah. And this is us. Because I always like to work in duality, the yin and the yang of a person. And you always have a side that's usually kind of like, that gets taken by making the wrong decisions, and you have the good part. So the taupe represents trying to find its way out of the ground.
Yeah.
By discovering yourself in the ground. And the dictator is like the negative part that's trying to like, not treating themselves good or not loving themselves or the world.
Yeah.
So confused.
That's oil, right, bro? Oil painting?
Yeah.
Oil?
Yeah, that's in 2012.
Oh, yeah, there we go. Fab Morvan 2012. Fabrice Morvan, sorry.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Yeah, beautiful name, brother. Fabrice. Sounds very elegant. Yeah. I mean, you are very elegant. So it really fits you.
I'll show you another one.
Okay, there we go. You see, guys, watching this, so Fab is a multi-artist, doing a lot of things. Oh, I'm not sitting very comfortable today. I look what he's showing. So it's almost the same colors. Not to say the same colors. So it's just like a series.
The gold series. And this is a more, this is my surrealist part. The other part is more like, it's less abstract than this. This is more abstract. This is more surrealism.
What do we see? You know, it changed so many things there.
Yeah, it says and talks about, because, you know, for me, that's my therapy. I paint, it's very therapeutic for me.
Okay.
I put a lot of, every painting comes with a poem. I would have to look for it. I don't know where it is. I got it somewhere, you know.
I see, like an alien somewhere there.
Well, you know, surrealism is, there's no boundaries between
the elements.
Animal, male, female.
Okay.
It's all other entities. So it's a story. And I wrote the story. I have it written somewhere because I don't remember everything, you know. But this is...
you should make a song about the story.
It's very personal. You know, it's my journey. It's right here.
It's really, really, really nice. I love it.
You know, there's a lot more. There's a lot of characters that entered my life. You know, things who try to take control over me, not being happy, trying to discover happiness.
But control, that's a key word I want to talk about with you.
What's that?
Control. Keyword that I want to talk about with you now. Jesus, this guy is amazing. Look what a beautiful house, the little plants. I'm a plant lover also. Don't think wrong now, guys. I'm a plant lover because I love plants, right? So, control. How do you manage to always keep control over the situation?
I found many ways, many different ways. You know, like I study dancing. You know, and I studied dancing, and then when I was a kid, I watched a lot of martial arts movies. I listened a lot to Bruce Lee, and they talk about, in all those disciplines, they talk about breathing. As well as in singing.
Okay.
Breathing, you know, and later, like about 3 years ago, I discovered somebody else called Wim Hof.
Yep, you told me about him. I entered the world of Wim Hof. It's a Dutch guy, right?
It's Dutch.
Thanks to Fab. Tell me a little bit about, so people know. You really should go and watch his website because it's amazing.
You definitely have to watch him. He calls the cold your best friend, because what we have, the natural one of our natural behavior in stressful situation is to, you have fight or flight, and by taking cold showers, you know, you take a cold shower and the reflex would be to run away. Oh, it's so cold.
Yeah.
But it's the important is to stay and to breathe through it. Just like facing on your depression.
Yeah.
He has an interesting story. You know, you go check him out. But it's about breath. Just like martial arts, just like singing. And also with singing, when I started to really focus on breathing, I noticed that I felt like the calm.
Yeah.
It kind of slows down the
So you go under the cold shower and you start breathing in a special technique. So
No, but not
cold anymore. How does it work?
while you're under the water, you breathe, because that's the only way you, because if you don't breathe, you tense up. You're like, oh, that's the wrong thing to do. What you want to do is not tense up. You have to take it in. You have to take that cold. And as a matter of fact, when I moved to Amsterdam, and it used to be a lot colder when I came here, like about 10 years ago, first time I came. And I met some very cool guys that I'm still connected to. And they were soldiers. They were in the army for years. And I was walking, we were going to a club, and I was like, bro, how do you do? You're wearing almost nothing. I was like, man, I'm fucking cold right now. He was like, he said, you know, when I was in the army and I had to stand there, you know, the whole night, you know, like, you know, to watch, you know, because I was doing the wach. I don't know how you call it. The watch, you know, the night the watch.
Yeah, it's a watch.
Yeah. He said he just let the wind go through him. And I had never heard anything like that. I was like, oh, that's interesting. Let the wind go through you. And with breathing, with all those things that we're talking about right now, breath is at the center of it all. So with the cold shower, when the cold hits you and you breathe, the breath allows you to just come and to out. Take on like those masters who walk on heat.
Yeah.
And they don't have no burns on the
incredible. On the bottom That's of their- incredible. That's incredible.
That's incredible. You know, it's not like the special effects guy on the side. Okay. No.
Put the right one.
Yeah, you can cook some chicken. I didn't eat anymore, you know, very rare. Cook some chicken. Fish is better for me. I love fish, you know. Yeah. I'm not vegan of fish. But it's incredible. So, and it all comes when you study all those various things out there, discipline or ways of doing yoga. It's all at the core of those disciplines is breath. So there's something to be said about that. So people, go check it out. But the simplest advice I can give you is inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Inspire, expire. In Espanol?
En español, por favor.
I won't do it in Espanol. I'll let you do it in
Por la nariz, por la boca. It's really not the way it's said, but that's the way I said it in my moment right now.
Respirar
y soltar. No, o sea, no me acuerdo. Si hay algún español por aquí, que por favor lo escriba en el comentario. Que yo no me acuerdo más.
You know, and what I do is, for example, when I go on stage, because, you know, the stage is stressful. And I always was very, you know, I'm a shy person.
Do you use the breathing thing when you go on stage so that you, because it's amazing that after so many years you still get nervous to go on stage, which means it's always like the first time, right?
I still get nervous, but you know what I used to do? I used to breathe because my heart rate would go up. The only thing that would relax, like I was breathing.
I'm relaxing already.
Yeah, but I found out later. That's so now that I know how to do it, I make really long breath, and I'm able to. I can hold my breath. I think for like three minutes now. I'm approaching 4 minutes. Yeah, wow. And
I can hold the vape like 3 seconds.
7 minutes or something. So I'm trying
to. This guy, Jim Hove, is really like 7 minutes.
Yeah.
So hold on a second. To recapitulate for the people, what Fab is saying sounds like a cliche because we actually all heard from, you know, this kind of breathing. Actually, it's what we do every day. But it's a technique that you have to develop by training, watching this guy, Jim Hove. I'm going to put the link in a way there. And then adapt it. First time, second time, third time will not work. Will not work. You will be running out of the shower, that's for sure. It's again the same thing. It's a game of patience. Things right. doesn't happen. Don't happen it, like it, that.
But you know, at the core of at the core of your own personal growth and progress lies discipline. If you don't have the will nor the power to install discipline in your soul,
then you're lost.
Lost. So yep. you have to learn, and you can make baby steps. We're not asking you to run the marathon. We're just right. asking you to run, you know, 100 meter to begin with.
Yeah.
That.
Well, that's back again linked to this impulsivity, right? I want to do it. I'm going to do it now. And then, no, that's not the right way to approach. Oh, today I'm going to go because I decided to run the marathon. I'm going to go have the best shoes in this suit because it looks good. And the other one, the dish, because I saw it at the runner and blah, blah. And then you run 5 meters. You're fucked up. You didn't even sweat. And that's not the way of doing the thing. So if you say like Fab is saying, I was going to say Jay. Sorry, Fab. When you start something, yes, be prepared. Have the best clothes, etc. But then prepare yourself also. The clothes are prepared, 100%. Now prepare yourself. What is it like you say 100 meters today, 100 meters tomorrow, 2 days later, 200 meters, a little bit, 250 meters. If you don't feel well, it's never bad to go down. If you don't feel well, just go back to the 100. The thing is, the trick here is to keep on doing it. But that's the problem of a lot of people. They start a lot of stuff. They get bored somehow because it's not the way they thought or the way they saw on YouTube, you know, because now I'm going to jump to another very important thing. It's like, what is the real artist life? I did a video like a couple of years ago and it was called 22 hours. And the 22 hours was about what people see and what's the reality. So they see us 2 hours performing, at least we the DJs, you guys, artists are performing a little bit less.
Right.
But the DJs, normally they play 2 hours. And that's what they see on YouTube, or they see when they are there live. And they say, fuck, this guy has such an amazing live look. He's playing and the people hands up and all the girls wanting to do selfies with him or whatever. But then starts the 22 hours. What is the 22 hours? The working at the studio to do the things, to be traveling, one plane, the other plane, again, control at the airport, because we spend so many, I mean, I spend more hours at airports than playing as a DJ, you know? You too, actually, you know what it is. So people have to, if you cannot love the 22 hours, you cannot love the 2 hours of playing. It's just not compatible.
And this is why I've become with time, like I said, time being so precious and me wanting to accomplish so much for myself, I use or I benutz.
Now we're going German now. Benutz.
German, yeah. I use time to make. When I'm at the airport, I write songs. I write songs and I even on my app on my phone, I have GarageBand. I can start to build the track. I write ideas. I write concepts. You know, I'm always like, I use my social media. I respond to people. Like I use it to a maximum. So that means like when I get to those 2 hours, like, I'm like, yes, it was a full day. But if you knew everything that I had done until that point,
yes, people like don't know what's happening behind the scenes. They don't know how hard we work for that. They don't know how much pressure we have. They don't know how much stress sometimes we have. But then you have the two kind of people, like you say, these people say, okay, 2 hours played. I'm off till the next 2 hours. It's never going to happen. And then you have the guys like you and like me, I have to say also, I take the Uber. I don't have a driver license. I don't have a car. They didn't take my driver's license away. It's just I never did it because I was too lazy for that. And I had a car. But okay, this was just in Spain, you know. So we were all a little bit crazy. Maybe I was a little bit more crazy. But we use our time. I think also that comes a little bit with the age. But I don't even want to have a car because to me it's stressy, and that time I want to use for something productive. So I always think I am being productive at, in the Uber, doing with my phone, same like you do, this, that, emails, real, how do you say, social media. And at the same time, the guy is making money, the Uber driver. So actually, it's a win-win situation for both of us. This is what you guys also should think about how can you make somebody else make money? Because it's always about how can I make money? It's like, how can I make the other guy make money and still me have a profit out of it? So I make the Uber driver make money, and my profit out of that is that I can do something productive, which I'm busy with. So
right.
Sometimes it's beautiful to think like that. Make somebody else make money, and you will get very much benefit out of it.
Well,
let me say it right because my English was wrong. So make or help somebody else make money, and you will be profitable from that as well. That's the thing.
Yeah.
I got it right.
The world we live in is definitely changed. And I think that the world always is continuously evolving.
Right.
But because it happened at the beginning of the year, the corona, it really pushed it in overdrive, this change that was happening. And it's up to everybody right now to look at their own lives and adapt to this new surrounding, you know, this new world. Because things are never going to be the same.
And
you haven't seen yet the effects caused, the result of because it's all about causality, cause and effect. As a matter, that's in the matrix. There's cause and effect. There's causality.
Causality,
you know, and you have to pay attention to the causality, and to the construction of what's happening, because when you see what's happening, you can get ahead of it and make your moves. Anticipate. Right. That's what I say. Anticipation. And when you can anticipate, then you'll be ahead of the curve, and then you won't be caught by surprise. Nobody wants to be caught by surprise. And that, my friend, that corona caught me by surprise, and now I'm making sure that my business, my everything, I'm trying to become pandemic free
right now. That beautiful set. I'm trying to be pandemic free. Wow. I like that.
That's the key.
The way I see it, I'm very, very close to how you watch it. I've really gone with all my businesses online, so I don't have to depend on too much of this bullshit going on. That's very important. Go online, because online is the future. It really is the future. Yeah. People, you have to open your eyes. It's online. Back then in the 90s, when internet was coming, everybody said, oh, no, this is shit. This is shit. It will never work. And right now, we cannot even live without internet. So we have to think those two steps forward like you're doing.
As a matter of fact, all the, and I'm talking about show business, huh?
Yeah.
And you've switched, people are already now, all the DJs are not traveling because of the ban on traveling and all that stuff. So they're now working with websites where they do live gigs, you know, streamed.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
So we're going to have to, like, and I'm already constructing, meeting people and see how I can do that. Because I'll give you an example. There's a K-pop band who performed online. And they made it fun, huh? They made $20 million in one night.
Yeah.
So there's something to be said. Like I said, follow the signs, see what's happening, think ahead, anticipate.
Yeah.
Of course, without this $20 million a night gig, but we should do things and start to build up something, because you got to build it and people will come. Just like what you're doing.
Yeah.
Just like I'm doing. Yeah. I'm building. I'm more people, more fans who love my music and who love me for what I am and what I spread, because I'm all about spreading love and positive energy.
Yeah, totally.
What we hear tonight, today.
I'd like to add two things to that. First of all, it is going online, and I think it's a very good thing, the whole pandemic thing, for a lot of stuff. People is starting, not all of them, unfortunately, they will come too late as usual, but the ones who are starting to reuse their mind and really be creative, because being creative with everything going well, it's not difficult, but it's now when you have to be creative. So if the show business was always like that, actually nothing happened in the last 50 years. It was always the same structures, you know, same patterns. So now that the environment has changed, that the situation has changed, it's when they also have to change in their mind and to start really creating new stuff, inventing new stuff. But the second thing is, complaining is not working. If you keep on complaining, you lost the game already. You know,
that's right.
So complaining is when you're complaining, this is brain function now. When you're complaining, the brain is depressive, makes the body depressive. We all know that. And when you're complaining, the CPU of your brain, let's say, the brain itself, is so busy with the complaining thing and creating complaining content in their own mind that there is no space enough on the hard disk to be focusing in the good things and in the future things.
Listen, I have one analogy for that. Complaining is like the anchor of a huge boat. That's it.
Wow.
So one that
I'm gonna cut that out and I mean, I'm gonna leave it in, but I'm gonna cut it later and repost that a couple of times, because this was very, very good. Very, very good comparison. Wow, I love that metaphor.
Yeah, the anchor philosophy. What it does, it only slows you down and it keeps you at port. It keeps you in the same position, which is confusion, depression, and not moving forward and not taking you where you're supposed to go.
Yeah.
So
I mean, also the people
and go to see and experience and live life. That's
people should know that they are talking bullshit, in the sense of, sounds like my father or grandfather, it was much better way before. Okay, yes. Guys, you were complaining the whole day before the COVID. So don't stick it everything on the COVID. Before we were talking the same. Oh, we're not selling records anymore. And people is not really going too much to parties anymore, because they just go and consume one Coca-Cola instead of consuming four whiskey cola. So do you want to go to that old normal again? No.
No.
Don't you want to prefer to start your own future?
And one thing I'd like to say is that, you know, as artists, we have been fighting forever. In the history of artists, we've been fighting forever to be self-contained. And it seems like we're approaching and entering the era of self-contained, doing business for ourselves.
Right.
There is a way. Right. You know, of course, you have the gatekeepers who control a lot, but with everything that's changed, as artists, we're able to do a lot. Now it's about this connection with your fans, finding people who really are into your music. How do you do that? You got to put the work in. Again, it's discipline. It's every day reaching out to people. Hey, I'm here. Hey, I'm here. I'm there. I'm talking about that. This is who I am. Where there's a will, there's a way. I'm going to have to disappear pretty soon because I got to do some things. But there's two things I'd like to say before I leave.
Watch out, guys.
If I was a samurai, I told you that before. If I was a samurai, my sword is my creativity. People, remember, creativity is your savior in the battle of life. It is. Okay? Now, the last one, because we were talking about creativity. creativity is like, there was a time I was a chicken. And I was trying to fly off the floor. Everybody knows a chicken can't fly really high. It goes up and down. Eventually, creativity will give you wings. That creativity is gonna allow you to fly high. And suddenly that creativity allows you to discover your powers. We are superheroes. We are all superheroes. We all have within ourselves a power.
Yes.
Discover, find your power, and you will become that beacon of hope for others, but also for yourself. Because because it's like when you're beacon of light, you have that tower of light on the coast, right? Be that for others, be that for yourselves, so we can see the shores of victory, because the shores of victory are there. Yeah. It's just a matter of using your discipline.
Yeah.
Every day, it all comes down to that. Discipline is the strength. Use the tools you have, but at the core, that's why the song, that house song, it said a sleep party repeat, but in my head, I had other words in my mind. You know that song, Sleep Party Repeat?
Yeah.
In my mind, it was like work, love, repeat. Give, push, repeat. It's that you got to do for yourself. And when you get that, everybody, I'm telling you, hooah.
Yes, sir. So I would like to, guys, everybody watching this, a very good advice. You should cut this part off. You have all your editors on your phone. What Fab just said now, if you feel down, just press play and listen again to what he said. If you don't have power, you don't feel power, and you feel like, shit, I don't want to go on, put that video. You will see. This is medicine. This is really medicine coming from somebody who did it. This is not hocus pocus, abracadabra, David Copperfield. No, it's the truth. That's how he did it. That's how many of us do it too. You know, so real quick, music, what's coming out?
Woo! Well, the fact of the matter is I've been focused on the French market. You know, je me concentre sur le marché français en ce moment. Ouais, and I've been preparing and stacking. Hold on, okay?
Yeah. Right, okay, so you see, this is what I love about those talks. It's just like we're talking. I mean, you say we're talking and we're French, we talk every day. And then I just put it on the internet. And then you guys can be like together with us. It's like we're a whole family now, listening to all this, to the valuable stuff that Fab is telling us, because this guy was really big and he's becoming big again, but in another way, in a very more, much more mature way. And that's what we have to be aiming to become the self, the same, sorry. Now I'm starting to talk Belgian. Actually, I slept 3 hours because I finished a new track. This is very important. It's called AMA. AMA, I'm going to make a little bit of publicity because it's not there. AMA is a new track that I'm going to do. Fab is back.
Rapid, très rapid, real quick. I've been focusing on the French market and been producing and writing the last 3 years. I went back to production and I was like tired of waiting and waiting. So through Paris, I was working on a project 4 years ago. It didn't work out, but we stay focused. We believe. And when you meet good people in your life, don't let them go. Yeah. It's very important. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, don't let them go.
In fact, I believed in them. They kept believing in me. We got back together. Now they're in a very good position. I'm about to give away lots of production and songs to various artists and friends.
We have a lot of writing for French artists also.
I'm writing for French artists in French and French and English combined. You know, that's one of the
perks of
travel the world and being able to combine both languages. And the French market, which is changing right now, is calling for that. So I'm at the right time, at the right place.
See, this guy is just in motion the whole time. And if this doesn't work, he jumps to the next one. Doesn't work, he jumps to the next one. It, the thing is to be busy, 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 busy. That's the
stay busy, but take the time to also slow down. I don't have the time to paint anymore, so I conceptualize a lot of things, because with me, it'll always be music, art, and also fashion. I mean, to clothing. But with time, you will see. Come follow me on Instagram, Fab Morvan, Facebook, Fab Morvan, Twitter, Fab Morvan,
Spotify,
Fab Morvan. We'll give you all the links, but that's how it goes. So, ladies and gentlemen, mesdames et messieurs,
you forgot the most
señores.
You forgot the most important thing, Caballero. The new track we're working on.
Oh, okay.
It's not that secret. Okay. We can say it. Jerry and I are doing a new track again.
But listen, everybody. Jerry and I, when we do something, it has to be of the utmost quality, because the first track that we did, Celebrate, was magical.
True.
And it is for the ages, that track, mark my word. It's going to come out of nowhere. We're like, oh, yeah, they were talking about that. Because when music is potent and powerful, you can't stop the magic of a good track. So people, even if it came out 3 years ago, people will discover it when we put it on the radar. Because, you know, we didn't have the right tools to put it on the radar. But slowly but surely, we are in a position of letting people know, like, yeah, this is really there. Come check this out.
Right. Fab.
But
thank you so much, my brother.
That we're working on, and
that's going to be a massive one. That's going to be a massive one.
Very sweet. Actually, we got more than one. We got two.
Actually, we have two, and one of those is like, it's not even house. It's not even reggaeton. It's so beautiful. I mean, I don't want to tell more. I don't want to.
We won't tell, but you know, we got to keep you, you know.
You know, brother,
all right,
you're going to pick up your kids, yeah?
Oh, no, we have to cut that out.
Okay.
I don't think we're okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, it was a pleasure talking to you.
My pleasure. What you going to do now? Where are you going?
There's some things, and then you and I.
Studio work?
I see you in audio, right?
So muchas gracias, caballero. Je t'adore, mon frère. T'es incroyable,
man. C'était super. Ça m'a plu de parler avec les gens, de partager aussi.
C'est ça, c'est partager.
Notre expérience.
Hein. Et offrir notre expérience.
Notre savoir-faire. Et aussi partager cette énergie positive. C'est important.
Partager, c'est ça.
And to finish with, there's a gift of giving and a gift of receiving, ladies and gentlemen. And when you start to understand that, we all gain power out of that. That circle of motion is powerful.
Yeah.
And then it goes like that. And then inside, we both, you know, vibrate and become more powerful. It's a teamwork. We can't do it alone.
I'm going to tell you something, and I'm finished. I promise I'm finished. There is this business model called MLM. You heard about that. Yeah. I don't believe in those MLM stuff at all. Only in one thing. In the giving thing and the sharing thing. So if we share our love to the other one, and he has his ramification of sharing love,
amen.
This could be so good, man. Just so good. And actually, we're busy with it. Since we were born.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for you to listen to a song called Celebrate with Jerry Ropero and Fab Morvan. It's a classic. Make sure to put it into your favorite playlist on Spotify. Let's go.
Okay, I'm going to put it right now. Thank you, brother. I love you.
Thank you. always been a friend through all my ups and downs. You really helped me shape my life and never to back down. When I listen to you say,